Hi everyone. First time on YouTube recording. I'm Mezza, Mezzacraft at Mezzacraft on Instagram. Go check it out. So, in my succession of videos, I'm going to show you a few things. This is a throw rug and a pattern that is very easy. It is basically a chunky wool. Doesn't matter what kind of wool. I just got this from Spotlight. And these are size 12 circular needles. You will need circular needles because the sheer size of it won't work well on straight needles. The straight needles just won't accommodate it. I need circulars. I don't like working with circulars, but in this instant, I have to. So let's finish this row. And these are 80 centimeter ones, by the way. They're not overly long. I'm on Instagram at Mezzacraft. Just shows you stuff that I make. Did some work for charity a while back, and still, when I get time, try and make stuff. Okay, so this is it, and it's such a great beginner project because it knits up really quick. So basically, the pattern called for cast on 70, but I cast on 105 only because I wanted to make it bigger. I'm not too worried about the tension because it's just a chunky throw. It's not a wearable garment. That's cool. Okay, so cast on 105, four rows of your garter stitch, and then you proceed in your stocking stitch. Now, when you do stocking stitch, the eternal issue of stocking stitch is it curls on the edges. This pattern says slip stitch the first two stitches. Okay? So by doing that, what happens is you get a nice ridge like this, and it doesn't curl. So basically, you start your row, one, two, and then you start your row, and it's that easy. Now, if you're a beginner knitter and you are interested in making something like this or even a scarf, please let me know, because this is the first time I've posted on YouTube. Yes, the lighting is bad. Yes, there's background noise. The heat has just come on. I'm from Australia, in Melbourne, and we had our first, it's been raining for the first time in a long time, so we welcome the rain, and it's a little bit cool. That's cool. So please, even though this is going to be a short little video, and I think chunky wool for beginners is a great idea because it knits up quickly, and if you make a mistake or drop a stitch or something like that along the way, it's easy to fix and keep going, and you don't get disheartened. I remember when I was a little girl and I started knitting when I was about 12, and now I'm in my 40s. I won't divulge my age. I didn't know anything about ply, I didn't know anything about needle size, I didn't know anything about tension, and I'd start knitting and knitting and knitting and knitting. Why is this taking me so long? My tension was awfully tight. And it'd take me forever, and I got so disheartened. But I did persist because I wanted to make myself something. But this chunky, doesn't know what brand, doesn't matter if you prefer acrylic or pure wool or what you prefer, is great because it grows quickly and you see results straight away. There's nothing worse when you're a knitter or a crochet for that matter. You start and you go, oh my god, this is taking so long, this is boring. But if you do it in chunky, you get a result quickly in this day and age of I want it now, and you get a wearable something, whether it's a scarf or a beanie or a blanket or even a quick knit for a baby that can knit up really quickly. And this wool, this particular wool is acrylic, but, and I don't usually knit with acrylic, that's okay, but this is soft and easy to look after. And stuff like this is ideal. We all know when we've got little ones, as I do, I've got four children, the eldest being in his 20s and the youngest being 20 months, things get dirty, things get, you know, nastied on, all sorts of stuff. And to be able to just throw it in the wash or quickly do what you're going to do is great. But then again, if you're a bit of a purist like me, I do things in pure wool because it feels nice and it lasts. It's a natural fiber, but that's just me. But I still enjoy some of the wool that comes out. It's the chunky wool. So, as you can see, it's very basic. But even if you were a beginner and you wanted to tackle a throw rug or a lap rug first, using a chunky wool would be the best option, I think, for your first project, because you get to finish and you get to see results. And then there's nothing greater than having something like this in your home, or you're going to give it as a gift or whatever the case may be, and people going, wow. And there's so much satisfaction in finishing a piece of, I remember the first thing that I ever made was a scarf. And it was like a Doctor Who scarf, different colours, but Doctor Who scarf. I've still got that scarf. It's got to be over 20, 25 years old. I did it in pure wool. I love it. And I still wear it. These days, I don't need a scarf on. And I love it. And it's lasted. And it's the first thing I ever made. Very proud of what I did back then. And since then, I've made baby stuff. I knitted little vests and cardigans for my children, blankets, scarves, beanies, squares joined together. I've knitted for charity. I've made gifts for people. When my husband works, people often, anywhere really, there's babies, there's birthdays, there's football supporters. So I make stuff. And I'm pretty sure, well, from the feedback that I get, people are pretty happy. I've also sold stuff, and that's so cool when you make stuff and you are able to sell it and people appreciate the work you've put in and buy it. It's so wonderful. Now, my issue with selling stuff is not making anything, but the labour that goes into it, you know. Sure, you charge for your materials, but then what price do you put on your labour? You know, if I do this, no one's going to buy it because it's going to be too expensive. You know, it's really hard. So, you know, a pure wool scarf that I've knitted, average length, I usually sell between $30 and $40. That's not too bad. And that's the end of the road. And once you get the knack of something like this, now I've just started this the other day. Yeah, it's not bad. See? Alright, so look, I'm going to stop. I'm going to say goodbye and have a bit more play around doing stuff and showing you. At Mazzacraft on Instagram. If you want more, let me know. I'll fix the lighting. Right. I'll see you later. Bye for now.